Not all protein powders are going to be good for you. A lot of formulas have a lot of fillers and added ingredients that are not good for you. So I only bring you the ones that I have already pre-screened all the ingredients on. Now I want to quickly show you a few other things that you can use in your personal care products. Think about changing out. I know this is a big one, especially for women or guys with great hair, but your personal care products, your shampoo. I'm going to show you what we use and we found, and I have searched and searched and searched for about 10 years because I am a hair product diva. And I just, you know, I like it to smell good, I like it to feel good, and I like it to look good. And most natural hair care products will not provide that for you. But here are a few that we use. This is what Doc uses. Let's see if I can get a good, okay. Right there, okay. This is the Max Green Alchemy. It's a 32-ounce bottle because you get the better price that way. And this is what he uses, shampoo. It smells divine. I mean, it smells so good. It is frankincense and other essential oils in there. Absolutely smells wonderful. I love to use it for a body wash. However, it's too expensive for me to do that very often. So when I have a big meeting, I always do it because I remind myself that that is the fragrance of the anointing oil of heaven. And then I smell like that going into my good meeting. Hey, it's all in renewing the mind. Whatever you can use out externally to trigger your memory of who you are in the power of Christ, that's what we do. So whenever I preach, I usually use his shampoo for my body wash, if that's not too much information. And that's why I smell so good. And it reminds me I have the fragrance of the heavens on me, both literally and spiritually. So he uses that Max Green Alchemy, and it's maxgreenalchemy.com, I think, MGA maybe. And it's their shampoo. It's fabulous. He loves it for his hair, but his hair is oily. Like he has to wash it every day, and so he uses that. Now, I don't use it on my hair because my hair is very dry and needs a lot of moisture. For example, moisture-wise, it only needs to be washed about once a week because it's so dry. Now, I do it more than that for cleanliness and for style, but moisture-wise and things, my scalp is not oily at all, and which means I have to hydrate a lot more than he does. So I use... And I have natural curly hair, if you didn't know that. All this curl that you see is natural. It's God-given me, and it needs special attention. And I have found, thanks to one of my girls, the most wonderful shampoo. If you have any wave at all or want some or need to take care of your natural curls, this line is phenomenal. And if you don't, I haven't had someone use it on straight hair, but it smells phenomenal because it's with essential oils. But it's called Diva Curl. Imagine that. And I'll show you the little label if I can get it. Let's see. Anyway, it's D-E-V-A, Diva Curl, and you can go to divacurl.com. And this is the no poo. Instead of it being shampoo, it's no poo. And so you don't get a lot of lather, but it cleans your hair and your scalp wonderfully. It smells phenomenal. And it leaves it silky, not fuzzy. Okay, so Diva Curl, and I use the no poo because it has no poo in it. Isn't that great? I love it. I don't know who named this, but it's wonderful. Diva Curl, no poo. It has none of the bad chemicals in it. Neither does the Max Green. All of the Max Green line is chemical free. And then I also use the Diva Curl One Condition. You know when people say on one condition? Well, that's why they named it that. That's the conditioner that I use. And then some of the other products in the line I have tried and not used, but I do use the shampoo and the conditioner. And then I use still commercial products for my hairspray and stuff. But, and then quickly, I know I'm going on and on about these products, but I want you to know, and most of this is girly stuff, but it still applies to the guys too. Make choices. Make choices for your personal care products to get fewer chemicals in, but they do make things that smell good and work good. You just have to find them. So sometimes you can save a lot of money by having a recommendation. And then the last thing I wanted to share with you, and this is for the ladies, is one of the most toxic cosmetics that you have is lipstick. Lipstick and lip gloss. Some of the most toxic cosmetics are lipstick and lip gloss. And foundation can be too if you use the wrong kind. I happen to use primarily Mary Kay Color products, but I use a mineral foundation, a powdered mineral foundation, and then I was trying for some new lip gloss. I was blessed with some Mary Kay lipsticks when I went to Kilimanjaro, and I love those, but I tend to talk those off, and so I always wear lip gloss on top, and that's one of the most toxic chemically laden things on the market. So I did some experimenting with different things, and I thought you'd like this suggestion. It's the Bare Minerals lip gloss. It comes with a little brush, and it's really thick and glossy. That's what I have on right now. That's why it shines for the camera, and it stays on. It's not a permanent, but it stays on really well for hours and hours. Okay, so that's the Bare Minerals lip gloss. It's phenomenal, and it's without all the chemicals that are bad for you. Because you ingest a lot of that when you eat off your lipstick or, you know, talk it off, you're ingesting those chemicals. So that's one of the most toxic types of cosmetics. And then there is a new company to me. It's called Tarte, T-A-R-T-E. And they have these fabulous lip stains. And it usually comes with a pencil point there, except I rolled mine up into the top accidentally. So note to you, don't roll this accidentally with the top on or it will come off, but it just rolls up and replenishes it. It's a stick, and it is phenomenal too. It's a lip stain, so it stays on your lips longer, especially like if you're going to be swimming or something, because it won't wash off. And it is that phthalate and chemical free also. So those are just some tips on how all things are permissible, but not all things are beneficial. Your shampoo, your conditioner, your shakes, things like that. Lipsticks, all things are permissible, but not all things are beneficial. And you can make quality choices to substitute products into your lifestyle now that are beneficial as well. So those are just some tips on the physical side today about some choices you can make. Let's make all things permissible and beneficial to God's glory.